Triton for testing all our modules, our branches, and stuff like that. So, yeah, we have a kind of specific setups with Triton, so I think it was good to share it with others. So first, why are we testing Triton? Testing is useful for many aspects. The first one is to verify that the code we wrote is working as we think it should work. Because sometimes it doesn't. So yeah, writing tests allow you to check that what you thought about what you were writing is really what you wrote. It also helps to prevent regression. So when we start to change the code, to improve or to fix a bug, it's a good way to verify that you didn't introduce another bug, and so that the software still works as you mainly expected. And this is very useful when we start to make refactoring, so when we change massively the code to like that, we are sure that we don't break anything, because it's the main issue when you are doing a factoring. And finally, also, it helps to document the code. Because when you start to write unit tests for the code you have wrote, indeed, you are showing how to use your code, because you start to use it to write your test, and in some way, it's a kind of documentation. It's a documentation for developers, of course, but it's a way to document the API and stuff like that. So people can read your test, and normally they should understand how your code should be used. So the specific challenge for Triton is that we have many repositories, one per module, and we develop on them in parallel. So that means we have often case where we change something and it should be changed in many modules. So that makes the testing quite difficult, because we have to test on the last version of each module when we are on the trunk, and so it's a challenge for testing application. We have also many backends for the database, and in some way it's good to test all of them, because database can have weird behavior. Even if we try to follow the standards, not all databases follow the standards, so it's good to test, even if we try to make to get a layer of abstraction between your code and the database, but still, it's good to test for many database backends. Also, we have not yet support many versions of Python, but soon we will support Python 3, so it will be good to test for both versions, because I guess developers will not spend the time to test the code on each version, so the test framework infrastructure should. And indeed, we have already some PyPy support for PyPy, so it's Python in Python. But it's not run for now, because we will see later there's a small problem with this version. And we would like also to test the review that we will submit tomorrow. And but it's not yet set up, but that's an idea for after. So the tools we use for testing is mainly unit test. It's the standard Python modules for testing. We use also Tox. It's a tool, useful tool to create virtual R for testing purpose. We use Drone. It's a continuous integration program that helps us to run the, to schedule the build. We use also CrudeFP, which is an in-house development. DevB, which comes from the same guide and docs, which help us for some caching purpose, and HG web caching proxy also, so caching stuff to reduce the load of the main server. So first, the unit test. So it's a Python standard module. So for Python testing, we don't depend on external tools. We rely on Python standard library. It's based on test case, so you write test case in inside a class, and it's part of one test case. Using fixture, so you have you can set up and clean your stuff after each test, and the test case can be grouped into a suite. That's the main design of the unit test module. So the test case in Triton, it's used to test only small unit methods. The smaller the test, the method tested is, the better the test is. Because the idea is to really just check the small part of the code inside this method. To see directly that when we have a regression, where it is in which methods. So the idea is really to test a few lines of code to be sure that the bugs is in this small part. But for to help developers, indeed we have a set of predefined tests that come from this class, the module test case. And so when you write your own test, you just inherit this class, and you have a bunch of new predefined Triton tests, and it will at least guarantee that your code is quite clean. For that, you just have to put the module attribute with the name of your module, and Triton will find all the stuff to test on its own. Of course, it's not enough to just inherit this class. You have to extend it, this class, to add your own test, because of course, if you write modules, that means we have written some more code, and so this part of the code should be tested, and you should test yourself your code. Of course, Triton cannot do that for you. So a test is just a method inside this test case class, and almost all tests start like that. We begin with a transaction. You have to use those parameters that you import from the test directory of Triton. It gives you a database name that is generated for you, and I'm sure it's unique. The user is the root user, so you have no access issue with that. And you have a default context that mainly is just empty, but we don't know, maybe later we will need more stuff in it. So each test is run inside its own transaction. That means it's independent of the other part of the other test that will be run. And for good practice, you should roll back your transaction at the end. That means that your test didn't change indeed the database, and you leave the database and the data inside the database clean from your testing. This is not yet completely done in Triton, in base module. In the first, the older modules have still some commits inside the test where we rely on it later. and indeed it should be clean. That's a good idea for the sprint tomorrow, to try to clean all this commit inside Triton. It will be better. We have a second kind of test for Triton. That's come also from unit test. It's the scenario. The scenario are used to test the whole workflow of your modules. So there you will emulate the behavior of your user inside your modules. We use Proteus for that. That's indeed the main purpose of the development of Proteus. It was for testing. So Proteus is a library that behaves like the client. And so we can just script the behavior of the client from this kind of scenario test. And we use the doc test. So it's a way to write Python code with, indeed it's like your command prompt from the Python. And it checks, the doc test checks that the output you will get from the command prompt is the same when you run the code and what you write. So here, it tests, it will test that the total amount is correctly a decimal of 100. And it will check also the precision. So here, you should have two decimals in your result, otherwise the test will fail. And to register your test for Triton to discover them, you have to get a method in this path named suite, and she should return your test suite. And so this is, can you see the end? Indeed, there is at the end a return suite. So the method should return a suite of test cases, and you can add as much as test cases you want for your modules. It can be, you can separate your test cases in different classes if you need, if you have this need. You can register your dot test also. That's just, you can mainly copy paste this, this in your modules and just change the names and it will work. The second part of the infrastructure is TOX. It's a testing virtual environment manager. So the goals of using TOX is that it checks the installation. Before using TOX, we didn't check the installation. And sometimes we find issue when we release a new modules because we forget to register, to set the setup.py that it should install also this kind of data or this file and stuff like that. So now the installation process is also tested. It allows us to test on different versions of Python because it creates a virtual environment for each Python version. And you, of course, you run this your test on each environment, so it will fail if any of those environments fail. So the default environments for which Triton works are those ones. So we have P27 is for Python 2.7. Of course, and you have, we have some flavors for different database backends. So we have SQLite, Postgres, and MySQL. We have also an environment for PyPy with only SQLite and Postgres SQL because I think we don't have a library for PyPy to connect to MySQL. But for now, on the infrastructure, only SQLite and Postgres SQL on Python 2.7 are run. So this is because MySQL is missing. MySQL has a lot of issue to run, and many tests are failing because of MySQL. It's not because of Triton, and so we cannot do much about that. So instead of having each time you commit an email that tells you MySQL failed, we don't run it, and it's okay. And for PyPy, we don't have, to get it to work correctly, we need to use the XML CFFI. This is and this version of XML is not yet released. I submit a bug for that, but it's still not released. So as Tox use the standard installation process, we cannot make it run until we have a current release for this version of XML. To run, Tox needs a comment to run the test, and indeed we just use the comment test of the setup.py. This does all the job for you, and it uses the Triton test loader that is defined in Triton directory, and it's managed to set up your database environment for you. And we need to, of course, when we run Tox, we need to know how to connect to each database depending of your local settings. So it sets some environment variable for you automatically, depending of the environment you are running from, and those are the one that works well with drone, we will see later, and so that's just a bunch of settings. And you see that we set up also the database name, and for SQLite, for example, we use a memory, the memory database to get the test run faster. And Tox, we need to override the default install command to use, as we will see, TrueDFP. We will see later why we need this overrule of the default pip installation. But also to get the --- pre option, because it allows us to install the development version of Triton modules. Otherwise, we will test only the released Triton modules, and it's not very useful because it will be too late. So, Drone. Drone is a continuous integration platform. It's built on Docker. So, Docker is a way to run container inside your server. So, the part of the testing code will be run inside its own container and cannot escape normally from it. So it's a way to secure the testing infrastructure, and also to be sure that you start your testing with a clean environment, because a new Docker image is created for each build. And Drone provides services like Postgres, an access to a Postgres server, and it's also via a Docker image. And that is clean after the testing, so it set up all that for us. And also the good part is it's written in Go. That's a quite good language. So you configure Drone using a YAML file, where you define here the image. The image is the image of the Docker that you need for your testing. And here we use the image named Python 2.7, because we are testing on 2.7. But indeed, there is other Python version in this image that we can use also for testing. It's just the default Python interpreter that is set up. And we define some the upcoming variables we see before to work with the setup of drone, because when you ask to drone to run a Postgres SQL services, it runs on this address and this port, and the same for MySQL and so on. So we just boilerplate to get both Tux and drone communicate. And we just need to install Tux, of course, because it is Tux that is used to run the test, so we need to have Tux on the host. And we just run Tux with the command tux-e and the environment we want to test. And we ask to get the Postgres services activated. But for that, drone was developed to be used with GitHub or Bitbucket only. So for that, I have to change a little bit drone. Indeed, I create a new provider, and I name it Tripod. So it's for it's a provider only for Triton, and it's this. It's a small Flask application that gives the minimal API for drone with the hooks on Mercurial to trigger the beams. And we get a drone after a build, trigger a hooks to Tripod for success, failure, and so on. For now, when we have a success, we do nothing. And if there is a failure, we send an email to the committer of the failed commit. On the to-do list, we have, I think it would be good to have a message sent to Irker. Irker is the small IRC bot that tell us when there is a new bug and stuff like that. And it would be great to get also when there is a failure there. So you can see drone in action on those two addresses. The first one, you need to be a committer to access for now. But yeah, that's you can. It's an incentive to become a developer. And otherwise, you have test.triton.org. It's just a web page with all the batch for all the repository and all the branches. And normally, everything should be green if you go there. And finally, we have another. So the problem I said at the beginning is that we develop on many repositories in parallel, and we have changes that affect both many repositories. And so when we run the test, we need to be sure to have the last version of each repository and modules. And as we are doing a reinstallation, so we need to install the modules from the repository. And for that, I wrote TriDevP. It's a small Flask application that creates, that automatically publish the last version of each package, Triton package. And it used the PyPy syntax, so indeed it creates a links for every repository with automatically a number, a version number based on the tags inside each repository plus one, because we want it's the next version we are developing, so it automatically generates the links for the future version of each package, and it adds the prefix dash dev zero. It's the way to number development packages in Python world, and you can browse this web page also. You will see all the branches and packages in development, and that's the links used in the Tux configuration to install the modules this way he fetched the last version when it's installed. We can go back. Here. This is the Trident key. I set up until now, that's enough for testing all Triton, and it worked. It worked like that a few times. But I find that there was some performance issue with this setup. For example, each time we have to build TritonD or any modules, we will have to fetch all the dependency from the PyPy server, and that's added quite a lot of load on the bandwidth of the server, and that's also not a fair play for PyPy, because we are adding loads for no specific needs, just for testing, so that's not fair to push this kind of load to the server. So DevP is it does a lot of stuff, but we use only for one feature. It allows us to create a fast mirror of PyPy, the Python packages indexer. And so we have on the test machine we have just this server running, and the drone images use this mirror instead of the main PyPy server, and so it keeps all the source file and stuff like that in cache, and so we don't fetch on each build all the source file and stuff like that. So it's also make the test running faster because we have it all in cache. And there was a second performance issue, is that as we install from Mercurial every modules, Triton modules, our server was also loaded too much when there is a lot of commits, especially for the release, for example, because each build will fetch, I don't know, 20 modules from Mercurial, and so our server was really slowed down almost, because we have a lot of parallel builds, and so that's a big load for our small server. And so I find this tool, AG Web Caching Proxy. It's a tool that allows you to cache a Mercurial server. So the idea is that you, instead of cloning from the Triton Mercurial server, you are cloning from this service that runs locally, which will keep a local copy of your Mercurial repository. And each time you try to clone, it synchronizes the local repository with the remote repository and you get the last version of your repository when you are cloning. So this reduces a lot the bandwidth because it fetches only the new commits locally and provide it to drone builds automatically. And you have nothing to do to manage the cache because it's automatically done by updating the local Mercurial repository. Everything is done by Mercurial and stuff like that. So, but the configuration was a little bit complicated because I needed to trick the DNS of the drone machines to get ag.triton.org to force the IP to a local IP like that. I don't have to change the host name of the real Triton Mercurial repository for everybody just to run on our local machine. So that's. And this tool could be used by any of you, because if you clone a lot of time Triton and all its modules, you can set up this kind of services in your office, and everybody will just clone from this local repository and will be always in sync and avoid to load too much the server. So if you want to be nice with Python, it will be good to use. So that's all. If you have any question. We test for SQLite and Postgres SQL. You? Here we have all the environments used, but only the Py27 SQLite and Py27 Postgres SQL that I'm using. I don't know if it's the question.
No, more or less. No, I'm referring to the discussion that we had yesterday. I suddenly had a when doing this test for this customs module, we had suddenly an unresolved dependency on the MySQL client, and I was wondering where this was coming from.
I don't know. But of course, when you run Python setup.py test, indeed it run on SQLite by default. I guess it's because it's a dependency of one of the dependency of the modules and so on.
Can you go back to the first slide? So I think I was going to take a picture.
Yeah.
Question?
How difficult is for us, because I don't know these tools yet. I have seen the files on the REPLs, but I didn't play with them yet. But if I create my own custom module that has its own Python dependencies, for example, how can I use this structure to test my own module? I can just follow the same principles you have explained to us?
Yeah. Mainly you can just copy all the files and change the names.
Mm-hmm.
It will mainly work. Of course, the drone file is not useful if you don't use a drone server. The tux, you can run it locally.
Okay.
In your module and run tux, it will work. Yeah, but of course, this is just the testing. And the testing will test the installation of the package. So you have to write the correct setup.py file with all the dependency defined in it. And for that, we have a template in Triton Tools repository. There is a setup template because it's good to not use to copy the setup.py from Triton because it's written inside the Triton project, and so it relies only on Triton stuff. But when you are doing your own modules, it's good to, we encourage to use prefix for your modules and not name your modules Triton underscore something, because maybe one day we will need this name, so we prefer that you don't register this name before us. And so the best is to prefix with your, many people use the company name, or but you can use also our group name. For example, the Triton Spain, use Triton Spain. Like that, it's a way to globalize. And there is few a configuration for the prefix. Because this is the name of the package, but your module will still be named with the short name of your stuff. But you can have naming collision, because someone else could have write also modules with the same name but a different package name. So when you define your dependency, you can define which prefix each module will have. Because setup.py read your Triton CFG file, where you have the module's name, and prepend on it the prefix the Triton D by default. But you can say this one is my own modules with this prefix and so on.
In the this kind of infrastructure can also be used to test the web client.
For now, we don't. Indeed, and the GDK client is not tested, neither. We have some tests in the source code of the GDK client and the SAO client, but for now we run it manually. And indeed, it's just test for some tools built for the clients, like the domain version or stuff like that. This because they are hard code base where we want a specific behavior and be sure that it's not broken. The other part of the client is quite difficult to test because it's event-based and it reacts on your behavior, on your clicks and stuff like that. Of course, there is tools for web testing. I don't know if we want to go this way. It's difficult to manage. You will need to set up also a server, a Triton server, to run it, and run after that. We need a web browser, and then you can script your behavior, but it's required to click on everything. And moreover, our pages are auto-generated. The HTML is generated, so it could be very difficult to say put the focus on this field, because there's no ID, it's just being somewhere. So, for now, I think testing with humans is the best.
Okay.
I have a question. I see you can share the repositories.
Yeah.
So, if you are trying to create a patch for a module that is on Mercurial, how do you handle it not to get it from the cache, but to use your modifications?
Here, indeed, the testing, this cache run for drone, it's not used when you run locally on your laptop. On your laptop, you will have no cache, because you need to set up yourself.
It's just so when you upload a commit.
Yes, maybe I was a little bit fast on the hook. The hook is a hook in Mercurial, in each Mercurial repository, that's call drone and tells him there is a new change set. This is the change set. So run the test on it. And so drone after that clone the repository, but using the cache. So it gets only the new revision and update to this revision and run the tux command on it. So that's